Consonant, please.
Thank you. B.
Consonant.
R.
Vowel.
E.
Consonant.
B.
Consonant.
L.
Vowel.
O.
Consonant.
R.
Vowel.
E.
And another vowel.
And another vowel. And that's O.
Right, and here's that clock. That time, John, what was that?
Six.
Six there, and Tim?
Six.
Six. What's John six?
Rubber.
Rubber, and Tim?
Bolero.
Bolero. Right.
Fantastic.
We've had
Spanish dance, well
we've had Bolero. Yeah. Right, and from Nicholas.
No, we can't. No. Can't do better. We'd spotted Let's both see. Of those, wouldn't we? But Tom.
Yeah, it's tough going today. Mm. All right. Very good lead here for Tim. He's going to continue with some more letters on the board.
Consonant.
Thank you, Tim. S.
Consonant.
R.
Consonant.
N.
Consonant.
P.
Vowel.
U.
Vowel.
I.
Vowel.
E.
Consonant.
N.
Vowel.
And O.
And here's that clock. Right, Tim.
Seven.
Seven was that?
Yes.
Seven, and John?
I've only got five.
You've got five this time. Let's have the five, please.
Super.
Super. And the seven?
Pension.
Pension?
Fantastic, yeah. Yeah. Very good.
Okay, what else we got well from done. The corner?
Pension was what that was. We've got two sevens, spinner. Mm-hmm. And neurons.
Yeah. Neurons.
We had neurons already this week.
We did, yes. Yeah. They're cells that transmit nerve impulses.
Yes.
Okie doke.
We use a lot of them on this show, don't we?
Yes.
Neurons.
We try.
How's your neurons?
Oh, it's hurting right now. Shaking about a bit.
Okie doke. 86 playing 27, and we're going to the numbers board this time. And John, once again, is going to offer them.
One large, five small.
Thank you very much, John. Here we go. 8, 2, 7 and 8, followed by 10 and 25. Let's see if it's as tricky as the last target. 869.
And here's the clock. John, 869, what did you get there?
Nothing at all.
Nothing at all. And Tim?
Nothing at all.
Nothing at all. Well, it's all down to Carol. It sounds like it's a difficult one. How difficult, Carol?
What did I get? I got...
apart from a sore throat.
872, so ooh. I was three away.
Just three away. Well.
Yeah, I'm sure it's possible, though. I'm just not on... This week, it's something in the air, you know, or the water here. It's affecting my neuron.
Is it? Your neuron's gone all nerdy.
It's absolutely, yes.
All right. Okay, no. Well, we're coming up to conundrum time, which means that Tim will be the winner here. But come on, John, you never know. We can get a nice smile on your face to leave with. So fingers on the buzzers as we reveal today's countdown conundrum. Tim's there already. Yep.
Marvelled.
Marvelled. Let's have a look at marbled. Marbled. It is marbled. Well, once again, Tim, you're a winner with 96. You seem to get better as this game goes on. Sometimes people go backwards as they get through the games, but excellent. Sadly, we're going to have to say cheerio to John. Come a long way from Devon. Well, you get the goodie bag, and we wish you a wonderful 50th, you and Mara. When's the date for that?
4th of June.
4th of June. Well, have a wonderful time, and we hope Chelsea do very well for you. Thank you for playing today.
Thank you.
And I'm going to ask something for Nicholas, because there's a little note here. We get these notes, you know, like a little dossier.
Oh, right.
Appeared on ITV play game show The Mint.
Oh, yes,
you
did. I did.
And
yes,
gave
yes.
away a first prize of 130,000.
Yes.
What
yes.
was that?
Oh, well, it was, somebody rang up with the right answer to some terribly complicated question, and the prize was £130,000.
Really? Because I've watched that, not often, but in the evening, it's usually it's like £10 or £100 they win. What's £130,000 to begin with?
It was an amazing night, I have to say. One other thing I must tell you, I was also did a thing where, wasn't on television, but the first prize was a new car, you know? You never hear of anybody winning these things, do you? And I remember the wonderful thing of picking up the phone and saying to someone, you know that raffle that you entered months ago, you've won a car. And it's amazing how people say, come on, get away, don't believe you. You know, you really have to persuade them to take the prize, you know.
Wow. Good news that was. Carol, you haven't got it, have you, because you were...
No, I haven't, but I've got another question. You know, I asked a question about the assassin.
Yes.
My question of the day is, what did cured ham actually have?
Answers on a postcard, please. We'll see you all on Monday for Countdown. Bye.
Into the slums of pre-war Limerick, Emily Watson and Robert Carlyle star in Angela's Ashes tonight at 9 on More 4. Here on Channel 4, Graham Norton and Carl McLaughlin live at 5 with Richard and Judy. Before that, though, seal the deal.